This conference will now be recorded.
Any questions?
No, I didn't practice yet, Mr. Wasu. Sorry about it, but I believe from tomorrow I will have more time. I am behind almost like 3 4 hours, so I will take care about it from tomorrow, I believe. Okay, thank you.
So we will discuss remaining means the small topics today. Okay, so first is MRP.
I can ask a question.
Right.
Just I'm sorry, I have a question, Mr. Vasu.
Yeah,
Here
tell me.
we have we are facing a problem with when we have a BOM, BOM, and we make a good receipt 101. We make a good receipt for 101.
Okay.
When we go to reverse transaction 102, it doesn't reverse.
What is the
Can
message you, you are
or
getting?
OFS not something like this and bomb explosion, the issue with the bomb explosion, you cannot fulfill it. Do you have any idea why or not?
And which system that is coming? Our training
And
system
if
or your
no, 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 not
your
in
real
not in
system?
the system, in our system, IS retail, but because we bomb, we consider the other article, the component is free. When it's free, we have a problem to reverse it. 102.
I think it is happening for that material only, or it is
When
for
it is
this it
only
is
when it is
happening.
oh,
Yeah,
sorry.
it is happening for all materials, only with the only that particular material.
Only for all any bomb it is when any component was bomb when we try to do reverse it never work out.
What kind of sign, Vasu say, what kind of sign you are getting?
Actually, error message is saying
Error, what is?
OSS not actually. Yeah,
Yeah.
if SAP directly saying OSS implement OSS not means you need to implement the OSS not.
Yeah, but we look at the OSS notes, it is very old and our system is very high, but the it is a wrong message. Maybe if I can send you the error message or I show you
Yeah.
how it work, how what happened. Maybe if I send you the error message, you can tell me what we should do in this case.
Yeah,
Maybe you have
sure.
an idea. Can you
Yeah.
just to ask you a question? We have many bomb here. Can you receive
Correct.
it and reverse it? Can you do you, can you do 102 for any bomb?
Yeah, sure, we can do.
Okay,
Yeah.
just in case, if it is possible.
Yeah, you
Yeah.
can record this one because okay,
Yeah, I'm
that's
recording.
fine. It's recording.
Already
Yeah, good.
started. Yeah. Okay. So, for example, you can see.
Honda car.
Okay. Honda car one in 0007. We
Yeah.
are going to do the goods receipt for this.
It is a bomb. Yeah.
Yeah, which is having the components. You can see.
Yeah.
Component
Yeah.
tier is there. Okay. So now I will do the backlash is there. It is still saving. I think system is slow. So you are saying component is not reversing. Component is 261.
No, both of
Hello.
them, I'm sorry, Mr. Vasu, both of them, they are not reversing. We are not doing 261. We are doing 101.
Okay. So we'll see now. This is order. Now directly I'm doing the 101. Okay,
Oh,
Migo.
okay, yeah. Migo and 101, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, I'm doing the 101. Our FG material storage location is 0001 and I am saving it.
What is the component here? Can we see the component, expose component?
Component will not come here because this is a goods receipt only. It won't come component here.
Hmm. Yeah, no, we have different issue. When we have an article like this Honda car, and we have in the second line, for example, the tire, the component direct. We order the item, the car with the tire, for example. But it's different.
It is a G transaction code. You are using standard Migo only.
No, standard 101.
Okay.
Migo 101.
Okay. But actually, if you are doing
our,
the GR, yeah, tell me.
Sorry.
Yeah, tell me.
Yeah. But our article first one, for example, it could be Zmer does mean maybe merchandise does mean maybe it could be fair or whatever, you know. We buy it. We buy it from the vendor, but with the vendor, it come the empty, the bottle, you know, the bottle, you know.
Mm-hmm.
This is what is the component, the bottle, for example. When we go, to, we receive. For example, 100 item with 100 bottle does mean one of them the component, the second line, 100 item with 100 bottle. When we try to reverse the, sometimes we have an issue in the WMS, he sent the double transaction and C2 sent one, only 100, he sent two time, 100. So we have 200. We need to reverse the second 100, we cannot.
Okay.
Here we are getting different bomb.
Yeah. Are you getting another line here?
Yeah. We have this is the bottle. It's come here.
Okay.
If you like, you know what I can do, Mr. Wasu?
Yeah. Can you send the BOM screenshot and what is the error you are getting?
Yeah. It's better if you send it, and maybe you can. You have better idea what we should do in this case because it's different BOM. It's not a production BOM. Retail BOM.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Please. If you can help, I appreciate it. Because
yeah,
sure. since 1 year we were working with SAP. Since the bomb it is zero value. We have a problem. They said, should both of them, they have the value, like a good receipt, an invoice receipt, or both of them doesn't have this flag in the PO. As soon as we have this is what we are facing the issue. And in MIGO, we cannot reverse the MIGO.
Okay.
So I don't know what you should do.
Yeah.
Okay.
Please
if you like, I can send you.
Screenshots, we'll see.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks a lot, Mr. Ross.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you. So I'm going to our normal topic, MRP on the net.
You are actually telling something about MRP, then you stop.
Yeah. I'm going back to that only for the distance. Yeah, if you come to the MRP, basically MRP is at the header level, it is a two types. Okay, this is called the planning. To plan any material, basically you have the two processes.
So today's topic is MRP what? Just MRP?
Yeah, MRP procedures, you can say.
MRP processes, right?
Procedures. Yeah.
Procedures. Okay.
So basically, to plan any material, you need to do the material requirement planning. That is called MRP. So this MRP basically is of two types. One is MRP. Second is consumption based planning. Consumption-based planning. we'll see what is this MRP and what is this consumption based planning. MRP means this is based on a formula. I already explained to you that formula is like based on your stock plus receipt minus requirement. Based on this formula, system will find what is the shortage. How much is the shortage it will find. Okay. It will find the shortage based on this formula. And if it is a shortage, that much quantity, it will create a planned order and purchase requisition. That is MRP, material requirement planning. In initial classes, yeah. Initial classes, I explained this actually. You can see this. Yeah, this is the class actually. Okay. Procurement type material, last individual material forecasting. Where is that? List. Yeah, you can see. MRP run steps, net requirements, you will get the net requirement. It is nothing but shortage based on stock plus receipt minus requirements. Okay, system will calculate this and using this one, it will generate a planned order or purchase requisitions. Okay, that is MRP. So the second method is consumption based planning. What is a consumption based?
Means any item is consumed.
Yeah, correct. What is consumption based means, in MRP you should know what is a receipt and what is a requirement. Requirement means is a sales order or
your needs.
Yeah, your needs. But consumption based means like some low valued materials are there. Okay, so low value or huge consumed materials, you will use the consumption.
Can you say the consumption based planning means consumable items?
Not a consumable. You can say, for example, you are using a sugar.
Mm-hmm.
You can say, you are using sugar in your house. Mm-hmm. Okay, will you buy sugar as 100 kgs? Are 100 pounds, you won't buy 100 pounds. You may buy 5 pounds. Whenever it is nearer to empty, again you will buy another 5 pounds.
That's correct? Called consumable item.
Yeah, okay. You can say consumable item also. Mm-hmm. Okay, but consumption is based on your consumption.
You will
purchase the, yeah, you will purchase the material again. Not based on your requirements.
I see. Yeah.
Okay. At the same time, you can't say like car is there. Car is not your consumable material.
Yes. Yes.
Based on consumption, you should not buy the car and keep it one more as separate.
Hmm.
Okay. Car is example of MRP. Whenever that car is not working, you will buy, then only you will buy the another car. But as you are driving, you cannot buy one more car and keep it with you. Okay,
right.
So those materials are which are high value material, those you will use the MRP. Consumption based is based on your huge volume based materials and low cost price materials. You will use the consumption based planning.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
We've got
For example, if you have the stock of now, present stock is 100.
Mm.
Okay. And daily you are consuming it. Okay.
50.
And it came to the stock of current stock. Okay. Mm. After consuming, it become as a 10 quantity. Okay. So then system automatically check Create. This what is the present stock and automatically creates creates an order.
Yes.
Creates a purchase order or planned order.
Okay.
Okay. You don't require again to what is the shortage, what is the receipts and requirements. System won't calculate because this method is based on your consumption, based on your present stock. Okay.
Can we use this scenario MRP whatever you say from the beginning up to now? Can we use this scenario in a discrete and a process?
Yes.
And process.
Yeah, you can use this.
Because you already explained.
Correct.
Before. Yeah.
Correct. MRP we are using in discrete and process also. So yeah. Wherever any kind of industry, if your materials comes under these types, you will use it.
In other words, you have to control the material through the MRP is the best tool. Best tool that you can control the material from MRP.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Now, you understood what is MRP and what is consumption based planning?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, in this MRP and consumption based planning, we have a different types actually. This consumption based planning short name is CBP. Okay. Consumption based planning. Now, in MRP, what are the types we have? And in consumption based, what are the types we have? We will see. First thing is MRP. Okay. Here I need to tell one more word actually. That is called the planning time fence.
Planning
time fence.
Time fence. Time fence. Okay.
Yeah. What is a fencing means in English? Fencing
means cover the area.
Yeah. Boundary.
Yes.
Okay. Fencing means your, for example, your you have the your house, so you will put fencing means you will build a wall.
To protect
your house. Mm-hmm. Okay, you will build a wall or you will build with wood or something.
Fence.
Okay?
Yeah.
That is fencing. So in SAP, we will call planning time fence. What it means is it is also protecting a boundary.
Mm-hmm.
Protecting a boundary with respect to time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. There with respect to your place, here with respect to time. What its meaning I will explain it. Now, you are a shop floor person. Shop floor means you are assembling a car today. Mm-hmm. Every day you will assemble the car. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But I am the manager. I came today and I will ask you, okay, you assemble a red car today. Okay, is it possible for you to assemble a red car today? To assemble a red car, you need to arrange all the components. Arrange all the components means you need to bring red frame, red color, all items, components, tire, engine, everything, seats, everything which are matching to red color car, you should bring everything. Okay, it is not possible for you immediately. If I say you need to start this product, it is not possible for you. It is planned something else. Maybe today it is planned black color, but you are coming and saying red color assemble. It is not possible. Correct. So in production line, changing a production is very difficult without a plan. If you have the planning, you can change it. But without a planning, if you are changing a product, it is very difficult.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. So that means with your plan should not be changed till certain period. Like maybe 1 week from today to the next week, next 1 week, no changes in my plan. Because you need to plan. If any change in the plan means you need to procure the materials. You need to bring all the its respect to components and everything. It is difficult, and you will lose the your production time also. Okay, so from today to next some days, like 3 days or 1 week, you want to protect your existing plan. You don't want to change that plan. Okay, that number of days is called the planning time frames. Okay, it is nothing but a number of days where your planning is protected. Planning is protected means no changes in existing plan. Okay, is it clear what is time plan? Okay, now what is the today's date? For example, tomorrow onwards, example 16th, you have a 17th and 18th. These are the 3 days. Okay, and you can see, 1 minute, this is example number of days, and you have planned Honda car production, like today is 10, tomorrow is 12, maybe 15, okay, 20, 15, 20, 10, like this your planned example. This is your planning quantities, okay? And you maintain planning time frames, number of days is equal to 3 days. 3 days. That means these 3 days, next 3 days, you are protecting, no changes. You have planned 10 means you are going to manufacture only 10. Year 12 means 12 only. Year 15 means 15 only. Okay? So you have fixed it. Your planning is fixed. Now, for example, now new order has come. New order came. Your sales order. You need to produce. The delivery date is delivery date. It's a delivery date means manufacturing date. Date your system is mentioned. It is 5th of September. So will you able to manufacture this? Today only one order came.
No.
Okay. You cannot manufacture. Then what is the alternative? Sales guy will come and tell you, I need urgent order. But as a manufacturer, you cannot produce it. Okay. So now this order, where you need to push. Okay. 5 quantity order, it came and they want it on 17th. So what we need to do with this order system? Either first thing is you need to move this order to the end of this planning. End of this planning means maybe, okay, till 18th I am busy. I may plan on 19th if it is a rush order. If it is very important order, I may plan on 19th only. That means end of the horizon, I will do the planning. I can manufacture your order. That is one thing. Okay. End of the horizon. Second thing is, you can straight away, you can say, I cannot manufacture. Because you are bringing the rush order, which I cannot manufacture. No manufacture. You can say these two options. Okay. So you can say means system can say. So you want to make this as automatic, we have a different MRP types. You can control this, whether you want to push that order end of this horizon, or you can say no manufacturing based on MRP type. You can control using the MRP type. So we'll tell you what are those MRP types. If you open this MRP type, first thing is, where is the time fence? You can see here is a planning time fence. It is just a field where you can maintain the number of days. Okay, and next is you can say, you can see these are the different MRP types. Generally, we are using the PF, PD. Mm-hmm. Along with this, we have the P1, P2, P3, P4. These are the different MRP types. You can see the name, new orders after PTF. No new orders. New orders. No new orders. So PTF means planning time fence only. So these are the different MRP types. Based on this, system either push that order to end of the time fence or it won't manufacture any order. Is it clear?
Yeah.
So you can use, based on the business requirement, you can use any one of these.
P1, and, P2 and P3.
Correct. P1, P2, P3, P4. Okay. PD, if you use it, it won't consider any your planning horizon. You create an order today also, it will say I can manufacture. Okay. But if you want to keep your horizon like this planning time fence, you can use the another options like P1, P2, P3, P4. Difference between is P1 is end of the horizon. P2 is no manufacturing. It won't manufacture. It won't consider the order.
Does mean you will not consider anything. Is that right?
Correct. Correct. No manufacturing means it won't consider.
Yeah.
Okay. Not consider for manufacturing. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the difference actually. Is it clear?
One thing I wanna clear little. If you go little up, please.
Yeah.
You said the program was before May 16, 17, and 18. Oh. 10 car, 12, 15.
Oh.
And then you have onwards another order.
Oh.
But then you have another emergency order come on 5-17.
Oh.
5 quantities. Oh. So you're trying to say how you can do this.
Yeah.
You know? So in this way, in this way, otherwise we have no manufacturing or end of horizon. So in this way, what we're going to do is, can we do the production up to 15 and then we start 5 or leave this other products?
15 means?
Means 10, means from 16 to 18. Can we do the 3-day production and 12 and 15 cars and then start the 5 cars and leave the other cars like from 19 May to 23?
That is up to your, first thing is up to your business. Okay, business means you told these 3 days means you should plan anything 3 days before. Okay. So again, you are saying, can I manufacture on 18th means if we have the that luxury, you can plan 2 days before also. So then you should not put your horizon as 3 days. You can put three only 2 days. Why you are restricting is you cannot do your manufacturing without planning.
Yeah, but then a new order comes. So what is the scenario that can we start the new order?
Correct. Or when the new order comes, that based on your business, end of the horizon, like your new order is placed here. Okay. So then as a planner, what you will do? Okay. Today I need to manufacture 25, whether I can manufacture 25 or not. If I am not able to manufacture this 25 in a capacity planning, you will move from 20, you will move maybe 5 quantity to next day. You will adjust all these orders.
I see.
You need to adjust. To adjust that,
can we have a scenario?
Yeah, you have a 3 days of time. Okay, for adjustments, you have a 3 days of time. You can adjust before 3 days only. Okay.
Yeah, but the, as you say, the MRP is to control the shortage of the equipment, shortage Correct. Of material.
Correct.
But over here, it looks like that MRP means that you are not controlling the material, but you are planning the material. Means you plan for 10, 12, 15, and then you plan another five, or Correct. Leave this scenario and then move forward. Means you are planning the material, but not the shortage of material. Am
yeah,
I correct?
I will come to this end of the horizon means you are considering this end of the horizon. Second is no manufacturing means salesperson is saying 517. Okay, so I am saying I cannot manufacture. Then salesperson should verify this once again, this order, and he will change his date.
Okay.
Till he changes date, I cannot manufacture. That is the meaning. No manufacturing means that means I am not going to manufacture. Not that meaning. That meaning is your salesperson should understand the order should be placed at least 3 days before, and same thing he has to communicate to the customer also. And based on that, he need to change his date, delivery date in the sales order, like 19th. Till that time, I won't do the manufacturing.
Mm-hmm.
That is a meaning.
Mm. Okay.
Okay.
Well, is that true, Mr. Vasu? We never use P1, P2, P3, P4. We are using all time PG, PG, PG.
Yeah, correct. That depends on the business to business. That is the reason, just as a theory purpose, I am explaining what is it.
Okay. Yeah, great. No, very interesting to know what is this, you know.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Okay.
You can, if you want to do the testing means, you can, it is very simple. You use the P1. Yeah, P1. And put the time fence, what are the days you want to, and you can save it.
Mm-hmm.
And you try to create a forecast before 3 days, and you can see when it is creating the order.
Mm-hmm.
That is how you can test it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. In MD-61, give an order with the 2 days date, requirement as 2 days date, and run the MRP, and you can see when this order is getting, means planned order, purchase request is getting created. You can see, test it. It is very simple.
Mm-hmm.
You don't require any other setup.
Okay.
So this is MRP, and in the MRP, these are the types. Okay. Actually,
yes.
The main thing is PD only, but under PD, these are the some varieties. Okay. So now, next topic is consumption-based planning. So in the consumption-based planning, meaning is based on the consumption, you are doing the planning. Okay. Under this, again, you have three types. Reorder-based planning. Okay. Second thing is forecast-based planning. Third thing is time phased. Time phased planning. Okay. These are the three categories under the consumption based plan. If you see this diagram, you can see material and consumption. Under consumption, you have the three: time phased planning, forecast based, reorder point. Okay. Now, what is these three? I will explain you. You can see the name. First is reorder based planning. Reorder means reorder. You need to order again, once again.
Yeah.
Based on what? Based on
your condition.
One setting. Yeah, one setting, that is called the reorder point. Based on reorder point. Now, for example, you are using a sugar in your house. You purchase the sugar, 5 pounds. Okay. You are starting consuming it. When you will again purchase next time?
When it's consumed.
Means you are
when I finish the 5 pounds.
Yeah, your or stock
you have a stock security.
Zero.
Yeah.
When the stock becomes zero, or when its stock comes to 1 LB, then you will start purchasing another one. What you will do?
Or your wife and farm you have. We have no sugar in home.
Generally, you will keep some stock when it comes. Mm-hmm. Okay, maybe a half LB or 1 LB whenever it comes. So that time you will again go to store and again you will buy another 5 LB of sugar. Okay.
Yeah.
Generally, if it is make a sugar as zero, that means that day you won't have any food.
Yeah, that's why I'm saying my wife gives you a tea and there is no sugar, and she say there is no sugar. Exactly. Without sugar, you have a tea.
Yeah.
Go and get it.
Correct. Okay. So to avoid those situations, minimum you will keep that stock. Okay. When you need to purchase next time is you will maintain a minimum stock. That is called the reorder point.
Right.
The point where you will reorder it.
Right.
That point is called the reorder point. Maybe in this example, maybe at 1 LB, you are trying to
place the order. Buy the
place the order. Correct. Yes. You want to place the order. Okay.
Yeah.
Based on this point only, system will generate next order. That's all. Based on your stock, system will place another order. Okay. In simple form or in the diagram, I can show you one diagram on this. Yeah, this is the diagram wherever you see the reorder point, this one. Okay. So what is the reorder point means? This is the present stock level, maybe 5 LB. You will keep reorder point here, maybe 1 LB. Whenever you started consuming it, this decreasing arrow means you started consuming it. Whenever it reaches 1 LB stock,
then
this is reorder point. Okay,
right.
Then system will raise one purchase requisition.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
Okay, to bring that purchase requisition, maybe it will take, for in the case of sugar, it will take 1 hour or 2 hours. Okay, till that time it will still continue to consuming it, and once the order comes again, your stock will increase. Okay, so your next order will based on only the reorder point. Okay, your next order only based on the reorder point. So that is the reason this planning is called the reorder point plan.
Reorder point planning.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now the settings required, whatever the MRP type, you need to select that MRP type here. Reorder point planning. Okay, here you can see. This is the reorder point planning.
Annual reorder point. Automatic reorder point. Reorder point planning. Can we use the same VB?
Oh, sorry, VB, not V1. Sorry.
Okay.
This one, VB, reorder point plan.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
So using this reorder point, here settings required is reorder point planning, this one, MRP type, and then you need to enter the reorder point here. This is a mandate. Maybe if this is a case of each, maybe 5 I will put. In case of a sugar and example, you will put what are the LB here.
You can put the reorder point should be 1 pound, right?
Yeah, you can put. No issue.
Yeah.
Okay, so
Yeah,
whenever
but
the
there is
stock
one
comes,
manual and one automatic. Is that right?
yeah, correct. You have the one manual and one is automatic. Manual means here manually you will give the value. Automatic means system will derive based on your
Yes.
consumption. System will derive this this reorder point.
Yes, yes.
Okay,
Yeah.
and this can be used in any industry. It is not industry specific.
Right. Yeah.
Is it clear this
Yes,
method?
yes.
Okay, now I am going to the next one, forecast based. These two
Same thing forecast.
Generally industries won't use it, only specific industries only they will use it. Okay, this is not regularly used, but reorder point is very regularly used.
Used.
Okay, if really they want to do forecast based planning, they will go to APO system. They won't do in this small method because of its benefits, means features. Okay, here in ECC this method is a manual method. It is not a very advanced thing. If they want advanced thing, means they will go to APO. Okay, but here what is the forecast based, I will explain you. Forecast based means based on your history, system will derive what is a future. Based on history means, example, in the month of January, Feb, March, April. So these are the past months. Okay, and your future means like May, June, July. These are the future. Assume that these 3 months are future. Based on my past history, I should know what is my future demand. Like car is there. Based on my past history, I should know how many cars I can sell in the future.
Yeah.
Okay, I can sell means how much is my demand in future. That is called the forecast based planning. Example,
based on
in
the
January,
based
correct.
On the previous history.
Yeah, in January you sold 100 cars, in February you sold 90, in March you sold 105, and April again you sold 101. These are the my sales history.
Last year
you sold. Yeah, correct. This year in the previous months. Okay.
Yeah.
Now you need to derive one method. What is your feature? Method is like average of all these.
Average.
Average. Average of last 4 months.
Average of last 4 months.
Yeah. 99. So this is my feature. The average of, you can say this is one of the method. How is your feature? Okay. Feature means feature months. I want to take average of last 4 months. How much is there? That much I want to produce it. This is called the average is called the forecast method. Okay, that is forecast methods. You will have a different methods actually. Trend
That's
model.
Forecast. The other forecast that we use in the before discrete and process, that's forecast is a independent requirement, IPR.
Correct, correct.
And this is not independent.
Not in it is only independent requirement only, but based on this one you are calculating. There in MD-61 you manually given, correct, but here system will tell you how much is your forecast based on history. Based automatically on.
Yeah,
it will tell you what is the your feature.
Yeah,
to calculate this feature we have a different methods, forecast constant, Constant means this is what is the average is there, that is constant. Trend
What is
means,
the trend model?
yeah, trend means, for example, ice cream is there. Your product is ice cream. So in winter, it's selling, means the sales is less. In summer, you have a huge sales. Okay, based on seasonality. So no, sorry. Seasonal is another method. Seasonal means, example, it is ice cream. Okay, ice cream is your seasonal method.
Seasonal sale.
So winter, your sales is less. So next winter also, you should plan only less. Summer, your sales is high. You need to plan next summer also high. Okay, yeah. That is called seasonal. Constant means like average. Now trend, what is a trend? Trend means, for example, iPhone 10, you are released into the market now, this month. So how is your sales? This month 1000, next month is 1100, after that is 1200. Like that, it will increase, correct? That is called the trend. Increase or decrease.
I see.
Okay, you have the old model. Before iPhone 10, there is iPhone 8 is there, correct? When you introduce a new phone, how is the sales of your old phone, old model, iPhone 8? It will become decreasing. It won't increase.
Right.
Okay, it won't become zero, but it will slowly decrease your old models.
Right.
Okay, that is called the trend model.
Trend model. Yeah.
So system will plan accordingly that trend. If you are increasing that sales, that also you will lose your stock will increase and you will lose your profits unnecessarily. You will manufacture the product.
So the forecast based planning is two kind. One is forecast based planning and other one is forecast method.
No. To derive these future values, you need one formula, correct? How we derived this 99? I put the formula average.
Yeah.
Okay. That formula is nothing but a called method. To derive your future, you need one method. You need to select.
I see.
So that methods are different types of methods. Trend model, constant and seasonal. These are the different methods. You can say different formulas to calculate your future demand. Okay, that is called the forecast based planning. Okay, and is it clear this one, forecast based planning? Any questions?
No.
Okay. Nicholas, you are not speaking anything, so you know all these things.
I'm here. Yeah, I'm here. Yes, I know the trend and the what is called a constant and trend, positive, negative. Yeah, I know. Yeah, because one project I implement the entire MRP is PT and consumption based. Reorder plan. One of them PD. One of them reorder plan.
Okay.
Automatic.
Okay. Yes. So now, for example, I can show you one example here. Honda underscore car. I am creating one material for this method and I will show you what are the settings you need.
Yeah.
Okay. And if you want to use this method, you need to select another tab. Forecasting. Okay, you need to select this forecasting tab.
Yeah,
that is extra. I'm creating car too. And in MRP type, first is MRP type. What are the MRP type? You need to select that MRP type only.
Means time base or whatever.
Correct, correct. You can see BV is a forecast based planning. And then along with the forecast based planning, you need to select the that tab details. I will tell you what is that. Remaining all settings are same. Okay. I press enter, it is still running.
Question, Mr. Vasu, was all this VB, VB, VM, and VV? We can run the transaction MG01 in again?
Yes, correct. Correct.
Okay.
Okay. Now, in forecasting, okay, you can see here different details. First thing is forecast model. Model is nothing but I told you that trend or seasonal. These are the SAP standard models. Okay. Trend, seasonal, constant. These are in the back end. It will have the formulas. Moving average, weighted average. All these are the different models, SAP standard formulas. For example, I will take constant model. Okay. And next is here you can enter the history periods and forecast periods. History means, as I told you, history of 4 months we took here. Okay, so this period you can enter how many months or years of history you want to take.
I see.
That you will enter example. Example, I will take the 5 months to show you example. And forecast period means in future, how many months of future demand you want to calculate?
Maybe
3 months. Okay. So I'm putting here the 3 months. But in real time history, generally we'll put 1 year or two years of history. Okay. And here period indicator M. M means month. So year 3 and 2 is based on months. Okay.
So if it's if it's not month, if it's like a day or whatever other, then we change the period indicator over there, right?
Yeah, correct, correct.
That will reflect to number of periods.
Correct, exactly. Okay, these are the settings we will use. One is a forecast model, another is a period and a number of periods. This is the main. Okay, and remaining things you will maintain the remaining things. Means my remaining settings are same. I'm just saving it. Save it. Okay. Now, how to execute this forecast? Now you put the you did these settings now. So how to execute this forecast? I will show you. In MM02, same material go and select your forecasting tab here.
You need a consumption, no?
Yeah, I'm showing that only now. Okay.
Yeah, okay,
here in the bottom you can see consumption values.
Yeah.
Okay, select it, this button. So you should know what are the values in the previous months, correct? To maintain that values here, you can maintain that value.
Yeah.
Okay, for example, last 5 months, I told you 5 months, so you can select example like 5th month maybe 100 and 4th month 90 and this month maybe 80. Okay, or otherwise I will maintain what are the examples there. These values I will maintain 9 101. Okay,
so 101. Whatever the month you mention, then you can put over here.
Yeah,
4 months, you can put the 4 months,
5 months. Okay, we'll put 101. Whatever months it is, it will come as average of this one. Don't worry.
Yeah.
90, 90, 100, 98. Okay. For example, these are the 3 months, 5 months. Okay. I am putting as a my consumptions. Now you can save these values. Save. Or you can come back. So you put the your feature consumptions here. Now forecast values. You can click on this forecast values. No. Yeah. So current forecast, nothing is there. No problem. Okay. You maintain the consumption values.
Have to run the MRP. Is that right? You have to run the MRP.
You can not MRP actually. You can execute
from here.
Here
yeah.
Itself.
Yeah.
You can execute forecast here itself. You can see. Okay.
Yeah.
Click this button.
Open the forecast. Yeah.
It is running actually. It will open another pop-up box actually. It should. Yeah, now it is saying forecast date. Forecast you want to this month, because today's date is 15th. You want to do forecast for this month or next month? You can select. I want the forecast for next month onwards. Okay, I'm selecting this as next month and click OK. Now it will ask you history is next 3 months we put, so it is showing you 6, 7, 8. Forecast is next 3 months. History, it is taking the last 5 months data. Okay, based on our setting. And here you don't require to change anything. Click forecasting. Execute. So it is you don't require to do anything. You just click on again forecasting. It is still running.
I don't know, the system is slow this time.
Maybe slow, or this is we are running first time. That is the reason it is calling all the programs actually in the bottom, you can see. So whenever you are running some programs first time, it will give you that. Okay, now you can see results it has given.
Yeah. Perfect.
Okay. Okay, you can see 99, 99, 99 has come. Okay.
And save.
Yeah, 1 minute. Okay, so you can save it now, and you can see that what are the 99 results are there. You can see in the forecast values. You can see. Okay, and you can save it now. Save. You have saved it. Okay, forecast is you have saved it. I think it should come in MD04 now. You can see. Okay. You got the all the forecast details.
Yeah.
Is it clear?
Yeah.
So in place of entering in MD61 manually, you can run automatically by using this method. But here problem is how to get that history. That is the main problem. For that everything advanced things and everything is there in APO actually, not here. Okay. So I hope you understood this one.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. I will stop the class now. Okay. So we will continue tomorrow.
Tomorrow, okay.
Okay, we will continue tomorrow.
Thank you.
Remaining topics. I will do one thing. I will take another 5 minutes. Is it fine?
Yeah.
Yes.
then we'll finish this time phased also. So then MRP topic will complete. This is a very small one.
Okay.
Okay, now you clear on what is a forecast based and reorder point. And the third one is time phased.
Yes.
Time phased. Name itself, we can see time phased.
Time phased means according to the time, whatever the
yeah,
time
correct.
For correct. The, for the consumption.
Exactly. Okay. Time phased. According to time, what is the time means? Means, for example, if you are purchasing a material, you want purchase that material only on Mondays. Only on Mondays you want to purchase, or you want to purchase only first of every month.
Right.
You have like that scenarios. So then you can use the time phased planning. So system will create its delivery date on that day only.
On the day only. Okay.
Okay. That is called the time phased planning. You want material to be delivered or manufactured on a particular day in a month, so you can use this one with
within
this
a
date
month. Within
yeah
a time.
Correct. So oops. For this, what is the settings you required is first thing is you need to create a planning. 1 minute, what is that? Yeah, you need to create a planning cycle. This is the word.
Planning cycle.
Yeah. First is planning cycle. Second is you need to anyhow, you need to mention the MRP type. Okay. This MRP type for this time phased is this one. Time phased. Yeah. R1. Time phased planning. Okay. So MRP, this is R1, and what is a planning cycle? I will show you how to create this. Only Mondays you want to plan, so I will show you how to create that.
Planning cycle, yeah.
Yeah. So to create this planning cycle, we have a transaction code MD25, I think. Yeah. This is a transaction code. This is called planning calendar or planning cycle. Okay. So the transaction code is MD25. Okay, so here you will enter plant and you will enter any name, planning calendar one, PL1, any 3-digit number you can enter and press enter. And once you enter here, you will mention the planning planning only on Mondays.
Now, what is the PL1 plan calendar?
Any name.
Any name you can put from your side.
Yeah, correct, correct.
Okay.
Okay. And this is the description. Planning only Mondays. Okay. And then press enter. When you press enter.
Can we put the time? It's already saying here global dates. We can put already before that, right?
Time is not there, only date only.
Only date, okay.
Yeah, on a particular day or date, not date, day only.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So, for example, work days you can select. So, here you can mention. Calculation start date means you want to use this calendar from next month. And which day you want to do the planning? Where is that? Yeah, on a weekday. Yeah, here you can see. The option you selected is weekdays, so select the Sunday, Monday. Okay, you can select and press enter. You can see when you press enter, it is valid from this date next month to maybe a next year or what are the years you can put. Click OK. So system automatically generates, these are the periods. Okay, for example, you can see from date 9th 02, this 9th 02 is a Monday. If you want to check, you can check 9th. You can see 9th, second is 02.
Yeah.
Okay. You saw this one. So system automatically generates that calendar actually. This is called the calendar. Mm-hmm. And you can save this calendar.
Yeah.
Okay. And then you mention this calendar in your material master. So for that material, system automatically creates. Example, I am creating another material, Honda Car 3. Okay. There is no change in other settings. Only here you select time phased. And here you need to mention planning cycle. You can see whatever we created, it will show here and enter. Okay, and you can remaining things is same. You will create your demand and everything, and but system will create a planned order purchase request only on Monday. Mm-hmm. Delivery date should be in the Monday.
I see.
Okay.
Okay.
This is about this.
MRP.
There is a two calendar, one of them for the planning, one of them for the delivery.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay.
The planning calendar. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So this is, you can save it, and this is about this method only. Very simple. If you want any material to be available on particular day, so you will create a planning calendar and you will assign that method here. Okay.
So this MRP that use, suppose we work some industrial area or some company in the MRP, and we have a material on certain day every 25th of the month that we use.
Yeah.
This 50 tons or 100 tons. So I can feed one time in MRP like this. And then, you know, every month I have to means process it.
Yeah. MRP will take care after that.
Yes.
Okay. Perfect. MRP will automatically execute.
Yeah.
Based on the number of tests. Okay.
Yes. Okay.
So this is about the MRP. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Sir.
Okay. Tomorrow I will cover on the FS and how to take the data from tables. Tomorrow I will explain
yes,
that.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
That's we'll really continue tomorrow also class. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice night. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye.